Rippling's Workflow Studio is a powerful tool for creating custom automated workflows and can be used to significantly cut down on admin time and errors. The workflows can also sync up with third-party apps to keep things as centralized and convenient as possible. If you're new to Rippling and need help with this tool, or if you're just curious to see how Rippling's custom automated workflows function, then this video is for you. So here's the Workflow Studio screen. You can see all the workflows you've already created here. To make a new one, click on Create Workflow. For those less experienced with automation, workflows, and triggers, Rippling provides a bunch of featured recipes that are essentially workflow templates that are plug and play. These are some of the more common automations that businesses use as a starting point. You can also see categories of recipes on the left-hand side of the screen, separated either by function or products or by using the search bar. Well, let's say I'm working with HR and I need some onboarding automation set up, so I'll click on Human Resources in the functions list. Here I see Send an Alert when a new hire hasn't completed their onboarding in Rippling before their start date. That seems useful, so let's click on that. It'll pull up the trigger and action of the specific recipe. Workflows are essentially logical equations that consist of if-then statements. Let's see what they have built out here. By looking at the title of this recipe, which is in conversational English, and then comparing it to what's in the tables below, we can see that they're saying the same things. If this is what I'm looking for, then we'll hit that continue button in the top right. On this next screen, I can name the workflow, give it a description, and add tags so that I can more easily find it again in the future. So now we can see the conditions and the resulting actions of this recipe. Because we're using a recipe, most of it has already been pre-populated for us, so we don't have to build it from scratch, but we can still alter it if we need to. If you want to add a condition, you can click on the little plus sign, and then a bunch of different variables will show up, clumped together in different categories. Under each category are more and more variables, allowing you to fine-tune these as necessary to the specific conditions that you need. Similarly, we can see the resulting action is to send an email, and the message template has variables in it too. Together, they'll automatically send an email with the relevant employee's name, onboarding status, start date, etc. This is all great and good, but let's pretend we want to tweak this a bit and add a task for the manager to follow up with their employee. So I can click on the plus sign below the conditions box and you'll see it says add concurrent action. When I do that, it'll pull up a new window to generate another workflow action. Here you'll see there's a bunch of different options for actions that can be triggered by the conditions we have already set. I'm going to choose assign a task. It will ask when the event should be initiated, who it should be applied to, with any exceptions if those are needed, and when the due date is. Notice that the choices change depending on which options you choose. So if I choose number of days after the alert is triggered for the due date, it'll ask me how many days it should wait. Below that, we'll see what the subject of the task will be, as well as a description. You'll notice the Insert Variable button right over here. That's how you can add in the variables like full name or employee start date into the message, like what the system built into the recipe. Once things look how you want them, hit Done. Now we can see the workflow and you'll notice it forks off like this because those are two concurrent events, meaning that they both happen at the same time, so long as the conditions above are met. If this looks how we want it to, and it does, I'll click the Create Workflow button. That takes us back to the Workflow Studio dashboard, and we can now see that the onboarding paperwork not completed workflow that we just created is in our list of workflows. We did it. If you want more info on Rippling or want to take a look at other HR solutions, visit our website at technologyadvice.com for our list of the top options available today. Hope that helped. Like the video if you liked it, and subscribe to us for more technology advice in the future. Thanks as always, and I'll see you next time.